Allergies are common, whether minor and seasonal or major and deadly. Ever wonder what causes allergies from encounters with seemingly harmless substances? The immune mechanism that is supposed to help keep you safe from parasites sometimes reacts to other day-to-day substances in the environment. Parasitic worms can enter the body by attaching and burrowing onto the skin and entering the blood, or through the ingestion of contaminated foods. The IgE antibody is responsible for fending off parasites, such as tapeworms or hookworms. Enter the mast cells and basophils to get rid of the worms. To simulate the response to parasites, we have this plastic bag representing the membrane of mast cells and basophils. The pencils are IgE antibodies. Once a parasite is detected, the IgE and the parasite bind to each other and distort the membrane as the antibodies move. This forces the cell to burst, releasing chemicals such as histamine, represented by the water, to kill the parasite. These chemicals attract other immune cells and can constrict airways, secrete mucus, and excite nerve endings, causing itching, coughing, diarrhea, vomiting, and sneezing. But if these reactions are supposed to be for parasites, why do people react this way to harmless substances such as peanuts? In highly sanitized societies such as the United States, there are limited parasitic encounters. The IgE antibodies are idle and therefore bored. When we are bored, we look for something else to do. For the IgE antibodies, this means finding something else to react to, creating allergies. We know about foods that can trigger an allergic response, such as peanuts, milk, or eggs, but what about something like poison ivy? The chemicals in poison ivy are not actually harmful to the tissues. The chemicals, however, trigger the creation of antibodies through the stimulation of immune cells called T cells. It is like a battle plan in your body for how to react in the future. In a re-encounter with poison ivy, the immune system is ready and floods the site of infection, in this case the skin, with troops of immune cells, resulting in rash and discomfort. Some airborne antigens can similarly cause asthma in the lungs. Why is this important? Well, this explains how a type of allergy medicine called antihistamines function, such as Benadryl. They prevent the histamine that is released from causing unwanted effects on cells. Think of the antihistamine as a shield, which would have prevented me from getting wet when the plastic bag burst. You might have heard people say that I used to have fewer allergies, but after moving here, I have so many more. This is because they might have lived in an area with more parasites, so the IgE antibodies were focused on removing the parasites and did not have time to react to harmless substances such as peanuts. A higher concentration of IgE antibodies in a person makes them more susceptible to allergies. Genetics and environmental factors can also contribute to a person's allergic reactions. So, the next time your parents say that boredom is good for you, you can say that an idle immune system isn't good for your allergies.